Hey peeps, how y'all doing today? You doing good? That's good. How I'm doing? I'm doing good. Today Thursday. Hey, that's a Thursday dance. Well, Thursday move. What? So today is Thursday, November 9th. Woo! There go baby Shay. Y'all saw her ass. She gave y'all an ass. She just turned in some word searches. Yeah. You finished all of them? Good job, daughter. Good job. And it's 12:01 in the PM. Y'all, I bought all these stickers. And I got a lot of stickers left. So, well, I ain't got a lot. But I'm trying to use them up. So when they finish their word searches, it's pretty deep. What does it say? Deep sea dazzlers, the sharks and stuff. And beginning, beaming bugs. They're everywhere. And frog fun. Baby ducks, like the ducks. Well, I see them. I don't know. I'm just not about the wildlife, the animal life. Frog fun. Did I do the frogs already? Yeah, I did the frogs. So now I'm on the flashy fish. So when they finish their word searches so I can use all my stickers, I give them a sticker for finishing up their word searches. Sharon, she was kind of sort of behind. Raina breezed through them like, and she just act like some mom, like, you gotta wait till Sharon catch up. So yeah, I'm putting these stickers on the word searches. Yeah. I'm going to use these stickers. Shan't go to waste. Sticker. And put it in a folder. So y'all, we got a couple of things I want to talk about. I hope it don't like just leave my brain, you know. It's real. So yeah, first was it, I thought I had something to say about when I was talking about the word searches. I don't remember. But anyway, I did my first Crock-Pot meal. Yay! Y'all, this the recipe I had used. I just got it off of the internet. Y'all see that date? That's when I printed it out. And it's called this. It was good. Oh my gosh. Everybody was like, the hubby was like, ooh, that tastes good. Shannon, but they always tell me my food tastes good. But I was like, this tastes good. I started like around 9 something. I started the crock pot going around 9:15. I finished like around, what about 2:30-ish? But yeah, it consisted of one package of frozen egg noodles, but I just bought the packaged noodles. Yeah, I was getting ready to show y'all, like I got y'all in my hand. And yeah, y'all know the noodles. They call the meat. I use medium egg noodles. Ring, go bring that bag for me, please. It's in the pantry, so I can show them. And it requires 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. I use 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. And sometimes she says she used 1 can of cream of celery. I had forgot about that, but I put 2 cans of cream of chicken soup in there. And 1 can of cream of mushroom soup in there. So yeah, these the noodles. The dry noodles I had used. I got them from Walmart. They brand. I think it was they brand. And I put some frozen vegetables in there. Frozen mixed vegetable by Pick. Y'all probably Pick. They better Pick something. Pick Way. What's they call y'all? Y'all know. No. Pick Sweet. I'm thinking.
Yeah, Pick Sweet.
Pick Sweet. Yeah, the mixed vegetables. I put that in there. And it had corn, carrots, sweet peas, and string beans. I put that in there, and I had to put a stick of butter in it, and I put some, they said chicken bouillons, or whatever that word is, but I couldn't find the chicken bouillons at Walmart, the one I went to, so I bought this, like, beef powder when we make our noodles, and I bought a chicken powder. For our noodles to make us like our own little oodle noodle thing situation. So yeah, I used the chicken powder, base powder for it. I used 1 teaspoon of it, I think. And I used 4 large chicken breasts. And they was like seasoning it with salt and pepper. And I added parsley in there. And I added some, I just used salt and pepper. I used garlic powder, salt and pepper. I think I put some other herbs in there. I think thyme. I put 2 more different kind of herbs in there. Y'all, I just was like, just put some herbs in there. And so, yeah, it turned out really, really good. But by me using the dry noodles, I had to add it like the last hour that before it had finished. Yeah, the last hour. So yeah, I had to cut the chicken. I let it like cook for 3 hours, and then I had to take the chicken out and dice them in bite-sized pieces and put it back in there and let it cook some more. So I think it cooked for over a total of about 5 hours, and probably around 1:30. I put the noodles in and then just let it cook to 230. And then I turned the crock pot to warm. I cooked it on high. So yeah, she got 8 hours. I did like 5. And it tasted good. So yeah, I'm really happy with this recipe that I had to share with y'all. Next time I cook, I'm going to do this pepper steak. That's the one I'm cooking that the next week I get. I think I got all the ingredients. I'm doing this one. The slow cooker chicken burrito bowl. I think I got everything. I picked up everything I need. So yeah. Diced avocados. Hot sauce. All them toppings. I need to get some green onions. I'll probably pick that up later. But that's the next time I have to cook. The next week I have to cook. It's like on the 27th. So these are going to be my other two. I'm fixing chili today because that chicken noodle soup, it wasn't no leftovers. That was gone. So yeah. It said 4 to 6 servings. I would have probably had to double everything. I don't know. For what there had been leftovers. But it's cool. gonna make my chili today, and I can't use my crock pot for that because I'm gonna put it in my big ten pot and everything, so I can have enough for tomorrow. That crock pot, it won't be enough. That won't be enough. So yeah, make my chili today. It's basically simple. It's just stuff I just add that I think of and I just might want to put in there. I switch it up different. I do it different most of the time. So I might add corn in the other day. I got a bit of diced tomatoes, chili beans, a lot of different type of spices and herbs and stuff. And they add their topping. They put shredded cheese on and sour cream on it. I don't really do all that. I just kind of keep my ass simple. And they add sugar to it. I was doing it, but now I stopped. They put it in their own personal bowl. So, yeah. I'll probably be putting that chili on around 2 when we finish homeschooling. And I can order me another light box. I guess it's called a light box. Yeah, it's a light box. Cinema light box. I got 2. I just got this other one today. It came. I'm putting them on my leaning stands. So yeah. And I opened it up. Let me see how it look. I guess you put the letters on there. I haven't experimented with it yet. But yeah, got a little cord. USB cord too. All fancy. Upgraded or whatever. But these the little stickers. I guess you put it on there. Okay, I see. So I got like a few little emoji stickers. Well, symbols, they not stickers. How cool is that right there? And just the letters. But yeah, I'm not fit to put it on there yet till I get everything I want for my leaning stands. So I'm just gathering everything, ordering stuff. And I don't want it too crowded, so I'm gonna make my styrofoam balls, probably start on it this weekend. Oh, I gotta draw it out. I gotta scribble it out to see how this. I don't know. I gotta scribble to see how I want my start. What color? Or do I want to put some stickers on it? I've been looking up some. I looked at some on the internet. Crafts with styrofoam balls. There's some pretty ones out there. They spray paint them. They put fabric on them. I mean, people be doing them. Oh, so I'm like, seriously? So now I'm like, it's so many ideas I got going on in my head. I got to choose one, though. And it's just like, oh my gosh. I don't know. I'm like, I'm most likely I will spray paint them. But it's probably just going to be, it's going to make it like a little garland. And I think it's going to consist of 6 styrofoam balls. And I got to see what kind of decoration or what color spray paint I want to spray paint them. I got to get that together. I'm kind of stuck though. So yeah, that's just basically where I'm at. And I think that's about it, y'all. Got my light boxes. I got it from Amazon. I think it's $19.99 each. Yeah, when I looked at it, because I ordered one because I'm like, I don't know if I'm going to like it or not. They run by, I need 6 AAA batteries for each one. I'm like, whoa, I don't think I was paying attention to that. So I got 12, but I hope, well, you know, keep them lit up, especially during the day. I might do it at night when the sun go down, light them up. cut it on, whatever. How do they cut on? Like, oh, okay. Just thought about it. Okay. So, yeah. About these people. I like the hearts. Y'all know I love my hearts. Got number love for you. But I wanted to do a read. I got a little slight headache. I've been trying to come on for like a week. It's been playing peekaboo here and there. I'm like, really? That's what we gonna do for the month of November. If you come, just come on and get it over with. Shoot. I don't know what's going on. But yeah. So I'm gonna do my read at this book. And this gonna be my Friday video, y'all. This will be my third video I've been gonna put out this week. I'm on a roll. Kudos to me. Yes, but I think this gonna be a good one, y'all. I'm on chapter 13, his trials. So I don't even know how long this video is gonna be, because I had to show y'all my recipe of my Crock-Pot chicken and noodle meal, which was delicious. I give it a 10. It turned, and it was real creamy. I guess that's because I used the cream chicken soup and the cream of mushroom. You couldn't even taste the mushroom. That I ate, he probably didn't even know he was eating mushroom soup. Yeah, pretty sneaky. He don't like mushrooms, but he ate that. You saw the mushrooms ring? You did? I didn't see none. Oh, my daughter, she moving out today. So, yeah. She said the weekend, but she said Friday. What'd you say, Shan?
Nothing.
What'd you say?
Nothing. I was talking to myself.
You talking to yourself, but I heard you, Shan.
Oh, sorry to interrupt
your video. We good. Y'all always interrupt my video. It's our video. But anyway, it was gonna be Friday, but she got to work kind of late, so she get off work early today, so it was gonna be Friday this month, so she get off work early today, so yeah, I told her she could have the bed and little stuff like that and everything, so he gotta take all that and her stuff. She got a lot of stuff, y'all. She got a lot of stuff. Shoes. The girl got so many shoes galore. Clothes. All that. So, him and the sonny gonna take all that. Y'all want to go tonight?
It doesn't matter.
It don't matter. It'll probably be like when daddy get home. My thing laying there. So, yeah. So she'll call her child number 6. She got a roommate. So, yeah. Anyways, his trials. Y'all ready for this read? Come on, let's do this. I'm not going to be able to finish this chapter because it's a little lengthy. I'm not going to be able to finish all this today. But I marked it where I'm going to stop. It all depends now, because I haven't been doing this video for like 20 minutes. It's probably gonna end up being a half an hour video, unless I just stop here. Y'all want me to stop here? I can't hear you. Do you want me to stop here at 20 minutes? Because I started at 12:01. It's like 12:21. You want me to stop here? Nah, I'm gonna get y'all the word. Y'all, we need a word for the weekend, right? Okay, let's do this. His trials. Everyone goes through hard times. It's nothing to be ashamed of. Sometimes our prayers help us to avoid them. Sometimes not. True. It's the attitude we have when we go through them that matters most. Amen, amen, and amen, right? If we are filled with anger and bitterness or insist on complaining and blaming God, things tend to turn out badly. Woo! If we go through them with thankfulness and praise to God, He promised to bring good things despite them. He says to count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. James 1, 2 through 3. That is so true. Knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. Man, I've acquired so much patience over the years. I'm telling you. I might not be as patient as Job was, but probably before it's over with, I might be. Because, woo, the stuff that be coming. Yeah, that's true. A wife's prayer for her husband during these times may not change some of the things he must go through. Must go through. After all, if we never suffered anything, what kind of shallow, compassionless, impatient people will we be? That's true. But prayer can help him maintain a positive outlook of gratitude, hope, patience, and peace in the midst of it. In the middle of it. And keep him from reaping the penalty of a wrong response. My friend Jan watched her husband, Dave, hoover near death as a result of being bitten by a poisonous spider. Oh my gosh. Spiders and a poisonous. I'm not going to even get distracted by this poisonous spider thing right here. It was a terrifying time for them both. And the trial lasted for well over a year as he struggled to rise above each new physical problem that happened as a result. A poisonous spider over a year? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. On the top of that, they had just moved to a new state, away from family, friends, and church. And they suffer financially because of the enormous medical bills. There was every reason to be angry and bitter, but they never allowed themselves to stop praying, praising God, and looking to Him as their source. Through countless tears and fears of her own, Jan fervently prayed that Dave would not get discouraged in the battle, but it be able to stand strong through it. God sustained them. They did recover, and they have become two of the richest people in the Lord one could ever hope to meet. Not only that, but their three children are all strong believers who use their enormous talents to glorify God. Woo! Well, Dave became a music pastor at a church where he and Jan now have a highly successful ministry. The lives are a testimony to the goodness of the Lord. And I believe that the manner in which they went through this trial has a lot to do with where they are today. Whether it feels like it or not, when we serve God, His love attends every moment of our lives. Even the toughest, loneliest, most painful, and desperate. He is always there in the midst, working things out for good when we pray and look to Him to do so. We know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called, to those who are the called according to His purpose. Romans 8:28. His purpose for our trials is often to bring us humbly before Him to experience a breaking and our inner, independent, self-sufficient selves. And grow us up into compassionate, patient, spiritually strong, God-glorified people. Wow. He uses these situations to teach us how to trust that he loves and cares for us enough to get us through the tough times. I can't think of any trial that my husband... Nah, I think I'm going to stop right there. I'm going to stop right there because she finna start talking about her husband and their situation. So, that was good. That was Jen and Dave. I wonder if that the that couple that used to be on TBN. Cause this book is kind of old. 1997. I think that is them. I think cause I used to watch TBN all the time. Dave and Jen. I'm thinking. I'm not sure, but that was good. And this just. I'm sure a lot of people, a lot of us get those type of stories where stuff just, especially if you believe in a believer of, you know, of God and believe in prayer and our faith, and, you know, you have to put it to use when, you know, terrible situations like come into your life and God allows these things to come into our life for a reason, as she had said, to make us strong, make us compassionate, make us humble, make us grateful, make us patient, all that. So yeah, when you find yourself going through something, God allowing it to happen for a reason. The thing is, ask, what's the reason? He's trying to teach you something. And it's to better you. It's always going to be to make a better you. So yeah, I done talked enough, y'all. I know I have. I just feel it on the inside. So on that note, I'm going to end this and I'm gonna finish this chapter in my next video and get her done. So I hope everybody have a blessed Friday, a safe Friday, a productive Friday. Get her done and have a protective Friday and weekend. And I'll see y'all later on in the week. I don't know if I'm going to have a Monday video up because I got to regroup from these three videos I don't put out this week. So yeah, probably put up one Tuesday. Or I don't know. It all depends on how I feel. I might could do one for Monday. Most likely it'll be Tuesday though. So I'll see y'all next week. And on that note, I'm out, y'all. I'm out. Peace. Good luck. Share some. And
thank you for coming tonight. I got a young man I want to introduce you to. We call him Ike Nice. Oh yeah. I'm a music major.
With tears rolling down your face. With your heart feeling like it's going. Like it's about to shake. And you've taken all that you can take.
Oh, yeah.
Just remember where your help comes from. Realize you got somewhere to run. Don't worry about what you're going through. Instead of worrying, here's what you can.